Ladies and gentlemen, I am Yuzrel, the game is Star Trek Online, and welcome once again to Foundry Frolics after many, many unforeseen delays, diversions, excursions, and indeed Vardware attacks. Unfortunately, I appear to have run out of spotlight missions on the Federation side. I'm pretty sure I have done all of these more or less. I may have to go back and actually double check at some point, but they all look familiar. So for today's episode, we are off to a radio blast from the past, if I can find it among all the various grinding options. Where has it gone? I had it a moment ago. There we are, a radio blast from the past by Telethaeus. A mysterious signal has been detected where none should exist, so needless to say, we are going to go and investigate it, and if it turns out to be certain death, well, the fleet admirals won't care. There are only so many rank pips to go around after all. Text heavy in the style of the original series, mostly ground-based combat. Right, let's go. Hail! We have received reports of a strange signal somewhere near Drazana. It's probably the latest Ferengi pirate station starting up, and they will be expecting a full report on the fundings. Plot a course for Drazana station in Eta Eridani. Well, we can do that. Also, meet the USS Kel, the offspring of a Defiant, an Eclipse, and an F-117. It's not too bad, actually, in a first impressions kind of way. I really do need to give it a thorough run round. But, look. See what it comes up with. Unfortunately, this is mostly going to be a ground mission, but oh well, can't have everything. To Starbase K7, and from there to Drazana. It's also not a small ship. I mean, lengthwise, despite having the shape of a Defiant, it's pretty much the size of an Avenger. I mean, just run those next to each other and loop around again, because don't particularly want to have range effects getting in the way. Yeah, there we go. That's about as close as I can get to that Odyssey. You can see that it's about, what, half the size of the saucer, more or less. Anyhow, onwards. Drazana. Must not get distracted. Too easily distracted. Also, pitch attitude with regard to warping. Either the camera angle needs to be made relative to the ship, or the ship needs to warp out on a flat plane regardless. Anyhow, Drazana Station. A little way to the right. Nose up. And slipstream! Unfortunately, we will not be able to solve the problem by beaming a warhead onto the bridge. Happily, by the way, yes, that does work with tri-cobalt torpedoes. It's rather amusing when it does. Drazana Station. Enter the asteroid fields and investigate the signal. It is apparently a pre-recorded loop. Well, let's go see how long the answer phone's been playing its message for. Right, so we are international field in the Drazana Station, signal somewhere in the area, and the data signature is antiquated. We stopped the format 100 years ago. There is a research station that's been abandoned for 150 years ago. Perhaps if someone was investigating a 50-year-old destroyed facility. Well, we've nothing else to work with, so let's go have a look-see. Also, yes, this has a cloaking device. Don't tell the Romulans, they might get jealous. Scan, 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 scan. There we go, deeper within the field. It was a trap! Of course it was a trap. Let's see what they've got. At least this, we get to see what this thing can do. Yeah, I'm on. Okay, so fairly standard on forwards. We'll take out this first drone just to make a quick kill. Boom. Then we'll pull up and we'll have some fun. So, begin with the EMP probe, just to get things detonated, and then we'll start exposing a vulnerability. Away you go. There we are. It's vulnerable. Right, line up the lance. And fire! That was fairly impressive. Let's see what else we got to play with. Transport torpedo. Have it. Well, I believe the expression is, all your base. Boom. And then we'll just go for conventional methods to finish it off. Rapid fire. And that's the end of that. Ooh, and both my little probes are back. They're cute. Dinky dinky little probes. A wreckage of a Federation starship, class and designation unknown. Let's go have a look-see. Well, if it's 100 years old, that means it's going to be, what, Constitution or similar? Here we are. And yes, it's a... It appears to be a... Is that a JJ Prize ship? No, too small. And the nacelles aren't nearly ample enough. Scan the wreckage. An automated broadcast. Play it. Captain's Log Archive. Download the contents. All officers aboard the Hamilton. What do you make of it? USS Hamilton missing in action. On a patrol near the system. Wreckage and remains were never found. And let's plot a course. If we get any closer, we're going to be on top of the wreck. Investigate the nearby anomaly. I thought we were investigating the ship, but okay. Right, we appear to have an eddy in the space-time continuum. I'm not sure exactly what Ensign Edward is doing in the space-time continuum, but there we are. Okay, what's your take on this? I must caution against using unknown gateways. Oh, come on, we do it every other week. Does it appear navigable? Yep, okay, told you. We do this every other week. If there's an eddy in the space-time continuum, you go right through him. It. Her. Take your pick. And we're right back where we started. Something's different. Well, yeah, that being the half a planet that we've got in front of it seems like an option. And let's set out for the research facility. We appear to have a starship in orbit. Well, what do you know? It's the USS Hamilton. It's not so much where we are. I think a better question would be when. Hailing frequencies open. Identify yourself. And yes. Let's just have a chat. Can't we just... Fine, let's go talk this over. A better question would have simply been, can we just compare calendars, Captain? Also, look at our ship. We have technology that makes you look like an inoffensive toy for toddlers, but that's hardly by the by either. Good morning, all you walking corpses. What can we do for you? Clear things up with Captain Fulks. Let's have a chat. For some reason, I think that might be a bad idea. I'm not entirely sure this is for himself. We're from the future. I'm sorry, the transport must have been this. Okay, we had no indication of the ship. We managed to realize, well, we travelled in time. We were here 100 and odd years from now. We'll be here. We're here. We're there. Ah, who cares? We should have been some kind of gate. A single elimination from the starship. Your ship, by the way. Wreckage. Perhaps that will help. So I have to show you that, Captain. Okay. The log tape we made later today. The wreckage of the ship was never found. Can we just get off this ship now, please? Okay. I concur. Officer, it's just that the damage is done. And, I mean, for all we know, we're the ones who blow up the ship. I'm sure we are. Tell us to meet it on the bridge. Fine. To the bridge. Ah, the nostalgia. The optimism. The days when we set out to explore space in day glow colours because half the audience was watching in black and white and needed a high contrast setup. Yep, we're going up alright. I like James Kirk, who, well, frequently went the other way. And here we are. Captain, you got here quicker than I did. Also, what are you doing at the rail? Fine, let's talk and see what they've got to say. If it's open, switch to the scene. Haksat, yehwebeth yin fathas check, sut yedist stin, katsaro. He's either got a bad throat infection or my accent's appalling. However, what? It's a broken translator, Mr. Sims. Adam's absolutely... Wait, you're telling me you didn't have it tied in immediately? I won't even try. I value my throat's integrity. Continue. Is it speak Welsh? No, there's not nearly enough vowel sounds in that for it to be Welsh. There we go. Okay, not too badly done. Apparently his translator's better than ours. I have constructed... Wait, what? Did I just double tap? Based on the rails of the human known as Sims, do you find this form appealing? Sims, I suppose we'd be grateful that you have not encountered the arduous journey of T'Lana on the road to enlightenment. A little after your time, perhaps. Continue. Yep, it does. What's your business system? How noble of him indeed. I must wonder that you do return the aforementioned researchers to their facility and depart the system network. Wait. Researchers? What? Oh dear. Captain, never make demands like that until you know who's got the biggest guns in the situation. Right, that was being boarded. Security team. Oh well, looks like we're going to go defend the bridge. Okay, right. This is what I need. Yoink, and shoot the hostile aliens. Because of one blowhard captain who really forgot that out here sometimes the other guy has got the bigger guns and possibly the better claim on the authority. Right. My crew deserve more than meaningless deaths. Well, I hate to break it to you, Captain. You're dead anyway. Predestination paradox. Unless you go with Everett's many worlds theory, but hey, I'll sod it. Of course we'll assist. Thank you. With you 100%. It doesn't really matter. You're all dead. Okay, to the crew deck. Let's go. Are they after the researchers? Possibly. Have you been engaging in a little unauthorized kidnapping? We shall see. Right, so we have one red shirt in his natural state, dead as a doornail, and some targs in the wall. Fair enough. They're on to us. Start killing them. Come on. Choppy choppy, shooty shooty. And you, down. Have a bone. There we go. Right. Okay, so they're all dead. Right. Let's just pull out this new weapon I got last night, because I have something I want to try out. See if this thing's any good. Can't really modify combat. You think I know that by now? That battleless is big as he is. Honestly, compensating for something? Perhaps. Apparently not compensating enough, but that's another matter entirely. Down you go. And yoink. Right, so that's that clear. Now let's see what this new rifle can do. Are we out of red alert yet? Yes, there we go. Right, so load it up. Let's see. Ah! Space crossbow. We're wanting to see what this could do. In the conference room. Not the captain's quarters. And, Yeoman, I'm not going to say a word about your positioning. Okay. Take a right here. The lounge is still on the force field. And the conference room. Here we are. Okay. Injured Jim Jenkins. Well, that's nice of you. I have no doubt it's got something to do with the fact we just saved your backside. And, go check on the crew lounge. What do you mean the doctor's not in sickbay? Honestly. What have we got? We have a grad student and some rather traumatized, including the Orion. Well, at least Mr. Sims will be happy. Okay. I got as far as I could. Not that it matters. Yep. She's a doctor, all right. Glad to be of assistance. Why are these aims after you and your team? The nature of this... What might that nature be? It phases in its absence when we first hear. More extraordinary energy signatures. How many extraordinary energy signatures are there in the galaxy? The first few expeditions are catastrophic. Lost them, didn't they? So the facility on an outlying asteroid, and what have they found? Surprisingly little. Sounds like a good deal for all involved, but why the but? Indeed, something to say with the life support systems. Terrific! And wait, the planetoid was inhabited. They have at least been attempted. They aren't just... Yeah, I suppose you get a few of them phasing out of existence, the rest get a little bit shy about coming out. Okay. Why have you not made the policy? Why do they want to kill? Right, fair enough. All clear down here. Terrific. Right, let's go chat. So. I don't think so. Come on. Let's see what this new weapon can do. Yeah, it's not too shabby. Fairly standard split beam rifle with a rather nice crossbow aesthetic if you fancy doing space medieval. I suppose the Klingons might like it. Come on, down you go. Down you go, I say. Thank you. Is that everybody? Yes, I rather think it is. Right, so, defeat the ambush, and we're safe. They were shapeshifted this time first, though. Okay, yeah, I will, in 150 years. 100 years, give or take. Not for nothing, this isn't over yet. Right, I'm sure she was soon. Aye, and now she is. Okay, they took the planetoid surface offline before they were able to attack us, and the planet phases in and out of existence. I see. Vaxi ride the planetoid as a vehicle, and yeah. Terrific, I concur. We've got to reactivate the pumps, the lifts are offline as well. Well, we could be able to get it onto our ship, which is all about. Can't we just beam off? I mean, grab the whole crew, mass transit them. Okay, we'll have 400 odd temporal dislocatees, plus or minus a few red shirts, but it should work. Admittedly, the paperwork would be a nightmare. Nightmare. Don't even ask. Mr. Sims is clearly affecting me. Right then, free lobby available. Oh, wow. Oh, okay, that's... Fair enough. Extinguish main engineering, restart engineering, and then inform Captain Fox of the... Right, guys, we have an antique to get back online. A top-of-the-line antique, granted, but still an antique. That's the transporter room. Main engineering is... Here? Question mark? There we go, right. Put the fires out. By glaring at them, apparently. Extinguish the fire before it blows up the old-style warp core. Done. Restart systems. Nope, we need to extinguish here as well. There we go. And now we need to restart the main board. Let's actually get a quick zoom on the map. Should be here. Here we are. Engineering lab. There we go. Reboot. The old universal translator. Size of a Roman still didn't work on spec. The number of problems that caused. Okay, so set up transport systems in main engineering, and then it all goes wrong. Beep, boop, beep, beep, boop. There we go. And then hail the captain. Done, right. Sims is absolutely, and if we're really lucky, he'll not come over James Kirk on us. Then again, if we're really, really lucky, he won't be off the ship either. I mean, not that I'm suggesting that would be the captain's motivation at all. Okay, let's go. Where before we head out? Yep. Wait, no. Right. I suppose we'd better be home, sweet home indeed. And we have incoming enemy ships. Terrific! Right, let's get on with this. What do we have? Varakhtsi ships. Alright, nothing fancy this time, just open fire. And you can have a torpedo as well. In 3, 2, 1. Which would be very satisfying. Boom. 10,000 damage. Not the greatest output in the world, but at least it goes right through the shields. Back you come, guys. Ickle probes. And then navigate to the planetoid. And then hope that this phasing effect doesn't have a range limit. Or rather, hope that it does have a range limit, because if it takes us with it when it's in orbit, it could get interesting. So, what do we have? Coming into range. Okay, you report to the sickbay, we'll handle this. It's on deck 2, third cupboard on the right. You might need to clear the cleaning materials out of it first. Space is a little bit of an issue on this ship. Oh, and when you get down there, yes, the Doctor is a hologram. Don't mention it, he gets a little tetchy. Right, here we are. Reactivate the surface pumps. Beginning the phase shift and preventing the travel of any more of Varakhtsi. So, all we have to do is activate the pumps and then get off the planet. How hard could it be? Wait, this is Star Trek Online. It's going to involve lots of trouble. Reactivate number 2. And then, beam out before we get sucked into the invariably fatal other dimension. He seems like a nice guy, doesn't he? Defend the pumps. Wait a minute, we're trying to help you. Be reasonable about this, guys. Come on. Down you go. Oh, great. Gone. Fire the space crossbow. There we go. All down. Right, start the pump. Okay, looks like the dimensional shift has begun. Excellent, you're in luck. So, excellent. I'm glad he does. We have the latest version of the emergency medical hologram on board. Indeed, Sherlock. I just don't mention the whole hologram thing. Well, I can let you have the program if you want, Travers. Let's start with not learning too much about the future and destroying history. Continue. Yep. All is. Ha ha. Sherlock. Apologies. You mean we have between time travel and alternate dimensions? Yep. Okay. So, Captain Folks, proceed but cautiously. There's some timed thermonuclear shutdown. What? Okay, let's go find the timed nuclear bombs. Because no Star Trek mission is complete without a very large explosion being involved. Gather charges. Yes. No, there's been a misunderstanding. Okay, and that's what we intend to do. Fair enough. Let's go talk. And then let's actually do this. Blow up the pump. Oh, hi, there you are. So, load the charges, and then reverse the pumps. And then stand well back, because we will be at ground zero of a rather large explosion. Yours as well. Godspeed. Energize. Before the bomb goes off, please. Right, front row tickets to the show indeed. The signal beacon is on board. And all we have to now is trigger it. Cue the bang. And if they got the planet through that rift... Oh wow, the planet must have gone through bite size. No wonder nobody survived when we did it every single time. Apparently the Vraxi can exist in kit form. It's a lot to take in. Yep. Okay, don't worry. I believe the Klingons will be along any moment to blow you up. Fine. The only logical outcome of time travel is the creation of divergent parallel realities. Or you go ahead and accept the chronological protection conjecture, which basically says that what has occurred will occur. However, you're still breathing, and apparently we fixed up your scars. So, Optimus is a logical response. Farewell, Captain Fulks. Make it so. Get us through this rift. The rift is that way, guys. Guys? And here we are, back in our own time, back in our own space. And should we form? Yes, let's see what we can find. Let's go take a look at the asteroid field. We shouldn't find any wreckage. In fact, we shouldn't find anything if the plan worked. A Constitution class starship. Scan the wreckage, and what do we have this time? This is peculiar. It does not match the previous readings of the Hamilton. This is a dummy ship. Try scanning the frequencies used by the Vraxi. Decode. Then stuck. This is a great loss. Right, okay, so basically she faked it up. Speaking of whom, a missing page in the history books. Okay. Right. Alright then, ladies and gentlemen, we have got to erase rather a lot of log entries. So, ladies and gentlemen, I have been usual. That has been an episode of the Foundry Frolics that the Temporal Integrity Commission can never learn about. So all I will say is computer, end program.